Hello everyone, my name is Nitin. I am a SAP Certified Development Professional. I am taking a course on SAP Hybris. In this course, I am covering all the topics of Hybris, starting from the basic to advanced. And this is a brief about myself. I work as a senior Hybris developer. My email ID is nitin.hybris@gmail.com. You can reach out to me over this email ID if you have any questions or concerns regarding this course or regarding this topic. So the topic which I'll be covering today is how to use IntelliJ for Hybris project. Although I have one video already on this topic, but today there are two points for which people have reached me, and they have asked me to demonstrate how we can use IntelliJ shortcuts. What are the IntelliJ shortcuts for increasing the productivity so that they can work quickly in their projects, and how to use IntelliJ for debugging purposes basically. So although I have that video, in that video I have covered all these topics: what is IntelliJ, what are the languages supported by IntelliJ, how to import the Hybris project into IntelliJ in detail. But today also I'll be covering it, but not in that much detail. So you can click over that over the eye icon here, and you can watch that video again. And after that you can come to this video to see what are the shortcuts if we use in IntelliJ, and how to debug your code into IntelliJ. Okay, so basically what is IntelliJ? IntelliJ is an IDE which is used to maximize the designing and maximize the development power productivity of a Java developer, of a Hybris developer. And it is a cross platform IDE. It could be used by Windows, Mac OS, or Linux, all the operating systems. So it is most powerful, popular, and fully featured IDE. Basically these are the same slides which I have already shown in that video. I'm just covering it in brief. So these are the languages supported by IntelliJ: Java, Kotlin, Scala, Groovy. You can see the full detail of the languages here. Next, why we use IntelliJ? Because it provides us coding assistance. So it provides the basic completion and the smart completion. Basic completion is that it provides you the naming, the completion of the names, classes, methods, fields, keywords, etc. And smart completion means that it will show the suggestions regarding the context of a particular file. So whatever will be the most appropriate keyword there. So it gives suggestions which are most relevant to the particular context. So if you are working in a file and whatever methods you already have created, it will give you suggestions to complete that method instead of giving any random methods which Eclipse do basically. So how we import the Hybris project into IntelliJ? You need to go to the file settings and plugins. You need to download this plugin, Integration for SAP Hybris by Jensens, and you just install that plugin. After that you need to import that project which is there into your Hybris directory. Just go to imports, select that project directory, and follow the instructions which I have shown in that video. I'll do it today also, just for your understanding, but still that video will be in detail, so just go and watch that video. Okay, after that, once we have imported the project, it will have segregated structure of custom platform and Hybris extensions. So these are the screens. So this is the plugin which you need to download. You need to go to the settings and just go to plugins and then download it. After that, you just need to import the Hybris project by selecting this Hybris option. This Hybris option will come after that plugin installation. Once you have imported the full project of Hybris, it will show like this. It will have three separate folders: custom, Hybris, and platform. Okay, so we'll be moving to the main topic of today's after import. So from where I'll start is, I'll start for these developers who are working into Eclipse and then they will be moving to IntelliJ. I'll be covering the shortcuts of IntelliJ also, but today I'll be covering the shortcuts which you are already using in Eclipse, because I was also an Eclipse user, then I moved to IntelliJ, and I was very habitual to the shortcuts which I was using into Eclipse. So I found a way how I can use that same shortcuts into IntelliJ so that I don't have to relearn all the new shortcuts. So what I did is I have selected the key map which is for Eclipse, and then I have started using the Eclipse shortcuts. So I'll be going to IntelliJ now. So today's video will start from here. So what I did is I went to file, then settings, and I went to key map. So key map is the second option. So after selecting the key map, I have selected the key map for Eclipse. So you can use Eclipse Windows, you can use Eclipse macOS, or if you use Windows, it will be by default IntelliJ shortcuts. So I have used here Eclipse. Later I will be moving to IntelliJ also, but first of all I will be like starting with Eclipse shortcuts. Sorry. Okay, so yeah. So once you have went to file, settings, key map, and you have selected the Eclipse key map, you are ready to use the Eclipse shortcuts. Okay. So these are the screens. You need to go to the key map, Eclipse, and then just select the Eclipse one key map. Okay. So these are the some shortcuts which we will be going to use today. So just take a screenshot, or you can just memorize them. So first of all, the first shortcut we will be using is opening a file. So to open a file, we will just click on double shift. So it, once you click double shift, it will open a window in which where you can open any file, like product page controller, let's say. So you can open product page controller, whatever file, cart page controller, whatever file you have made, you can go and open it from here. It has four options: all, classes, files, symbols, actions. Whatever you want to search, you can search it from here. So whatever Eclipse was providing into types, that can be found into this classes. So whatever type you want to open, you can open it from here. Or basically I use the all options, so this will provide me all options. So if I want to open a tag file also from here, so that is also there. So this was the first shortcut, double shift. So once whenever you want to open a file, just click double shift. Next is keyword search. So keyword search means, let's say I'm on my product page controller and I want to search for a keyword into the full project or into the whole project. So let's say I want to search this keyword. What I'll do is control and then H. So this is our second second shortcut, control H. So control H will give you this file in path option, window, and here you can search anything which you want in my full project. So if I open this one, this will provide me some options like match case, words, rejects, or file mask. So file mask is the one which I use most. File mask will provide you the extension which you want to use. So I will be searching it into the whole project. So I'll use the *.*. So after that, it will show me all the files which are containing this particular text. Let's use for product facade, for example. Okay. So I have typed product facade and I just want to search it into the Java file. So *.java. So I'll give the extension as Java. If I want to search it into the XML file, I give it as XML. Let's say if you want to search for a particular component, we have created one XML file, training email process. I created in my last video. So I just need to search it into the XML file. So these are the XML files which are containing training email process. Okay, index. Let's search something into my index. Control H. I'll go and I'll type as CMS paragraph. Let's see. And I want to search it into my index files. So I'll go to *.index. Okay, CMS paragraph. So see. Whatever files are having CMS paragraph, it will give you the results of those files. The best part is that this search is very fast. So if I'm searching anything, it will show me the result instantaneously instead of taking too much time. Okay, so second shortcut we have done. Third one is opening the method definitions. So whatever methods you have in this particular file, if you want to see what are the methods available, so just press Ctrl and then O. Control O will open all the methods which are there in this file. So if I want to search for this method. Let's say if I open product data, so in product data I have created one new attribute in my last video. It was the get reviews PLP. So this method is being created by getter and setter of for this file. So I just need to go search for get PLP reviews. So just press Control O, get reviews. So you'll open this method. You'll go to this method. Open any file. Press Control O. You will be having the access to all the methods which are there. So if I search for setup like this. Whatever methods are there, it will open those methods to you, and it is very very fast, and that is the best part of IntelliJ, very fast, and that is why it increases the productivity of a developer. Okay, third one is done. Control H is for searching a keyword in my whole project, and also if you want to search something and you just want to modify which directory you want to use specifically, so you can do it from here also. You can set the scope also from here. So I was searching in my full project. You can mention one directory which you want to use. Let's say we are working on only electronic store, so we can mention which directory we want to use from here. Okay, just mention what directory you want to use. Okay, so this is done. Control O. Let's say if you want to delete a full line, you have written a very big line. Instead of selecting and deleting it, just press Control D. Control D will delete that particular line. Control D will delete the row, the full row. Let's say if you want to open all the editors which are there, all the recent editors which you will be working on. So whatever files I have opened recently, I can access them by Control E. So if I press Control E, it will open all the recent files which I have used here. Libraries, project, wherever like in Todo, wherever whichever window I have opened or I have used, it will show me all the files which I have opened recently. Control. So if you see here, I have opened product detail panel dot tag, project dot properties, product facade, like this. All the editors which I have. Okay, if I have Hybris editor, so it will open my Hybris editor. So this is for Control E. Next is going to a particular cursor. Let's say you are working into a project and you missed your cursor here. So now you want to see where at what line you were writing. So just press Control M and you will move to that particular cursor. So if I have my cursor here, I don't know where it is. So I press Control M, I'll go to the line which I was writing. So this happens most of the time with me. So I am writing something here and I go to check the constants from here. Okay, now I need to search for my cursor where it was and which line I was writing. So instead of that, just press Control M, it will go here to the particular cursor. So you can Control M means marker, wherever that mark is, you can remember whatever you want to, however you want to remember it. Just remember it. I use it Control M to go to my particular marker. Indentation means if your project setup is like this and you want to line it, so just press Control I, it will indent your project. Whatever indentation we want to do, you can press Control I and that it will indent your code. I, this is not L or 1, it is I for iris. Okay, now checking method usage. So you want to check this particular method from where it has been called in my full project. It's very simple. Just click on that, click on Control and open, click on that particular method, press Control and click on it. Get multidimensional. So get multidimensional is called from here, these much places. These are the files which is calling that particular method. So this same thing, you if you do in Eclipse, you need to press Control G, I believe. But this is very simple. Just hold Control and click on that particular method. It will show all the usages which are there in the full project. So this is very useful. So most of the time we want to check which this method is called from where. So just Control and then click on it. This call from only one place. I need to check from where this popular prices are being called. Is being called. Click on it. You will reach it here. So this is the method which is being called. Like this. Or let's say get volume price rule flag. This is not being used anywhere. So this is also you can know. It will show there is no usage. this method is being called here. Just simple thing is that just press Control and click on the particular method. Next is the implementation. If you implement some method, then you need to check where you have implemented, where its implementation is being written. So for that, what you need to do is you just need to press Control Alt B. Okay, let's say I have some method, for example, get this one. I'll select some method from some service. Product facade itself. So I have some certain methods into my interface, and I want to check from where this method is being implemented. So what I'll do is Control Alt B. This will open the file which is having the implementation of this particular method. So default product facade.java is the file which is having the implementation for this method. Let's say I want to check who's implementing this interface. So I'll do Control Alt B on after clicking on this particular interface, and these are the two files which are implementing this particular facade. So this product variant default facade is also implementing this interface, and default product facade is also implementing this particular interface. Also, one bonus tip: if you click on this I icon here, so it will also show the same thing. So either use Control Alt B or use this. So I need to check whether it is being. Yes, so it can be used for particular method also. Click on I and it will show which method file is having the implementation for this particular method. If some method is implemented by more than one classes, it will show that also. So if you extend something and you write your own implementation, your implementation, and apart from that the other implementation also which was there into a out of the box file, that will also being shown here. Okay, so Control Alt B or click on this particular icon here. Okay. See, so it's very fast. That is the best part of it. Okay, next. So I am covering only certain shortcuts which are useful for us, like for us developers. I'm not covering all of them. My goal is not to confuse you. My goal is to increase your productivity. So only these shortcuts are enough to increase your productivity. You can go through other shortcuts also. I'll mention them into description, or I will be creating a blog and I will be mentioning it there. We'll later attach into the description. But I believe this much shortcuts are sufficient for your for increasing your productivity. Now I have moved from this file to this file and moved here. So I need to, like, I am writing a implementation of a particular method. Let's say I have implemented this method and I have written it into this class. I just need to move to and fro between these classes. So what I am going to do is just press Alt and then arrow key. So if I click on Alt and go to arrow key, so it will go to my last cursor, wherever I had my last cursor in a single file also, in different files also. So I have clicked here and on line number 35, then line number 44. So I'll press Alt and the arrow key. See, right, left. So what it's doing is I am going to my cursor, wherever I post my cursor into my previous file. So this is a very useful shortcut, Alt arrow. So if you have noted something, these are all control related shortcuts. These are some shortcuts which are having Alt also in between. Okay, so if you want to navigate between methods also, that also you can do. So Alt, let's say this method is there. So if you want to see between methods also, you can navigate. So it's the same key basically. Okay, now opening the Project Explorer. So you don't need to open the Project Explorer by clicking here all the time, minimizing it, clicking it here, minimizing it. So instead, use Alt 1. This is not I or L, it's 1, numeric 1. Alt and 1. Click on Alt 1, it will open. Click on Alt 1 again, it will minimize it. So it's very easy and fast. Next is opening settings. So it's very, very rarely used, but still I have included this shortcut. Control Alt S. So press Control Alt and then S, it will open your settings. So if you want to change the key map, you can do it directly here from here, or you can go to file and then settings. So it's the same thing, it's written here also, Control Alt S. Okay, now opening the implementation. So as I said, opening the implementation, I think I have repeated it. So it's the same, Control Alt B. So you can skip this shortcut, that's already covered here. Next is adding the breakpoint. So for debugging purposes, you want to add the breakpoint, it's Control Shift B. Control Shift and B. So this breakpoint is being implemented here. So if you want to debug your code and you want the debugger to stop here, Control Shift and then B. So it is there. Now if you start your debugger, it will put a check mark here. Anyways, that also will be covering in this video later. But for now, these are the shortcuts which are useful for you, which will increase your productivity, and these are for Eclipse users. So whoever was using Eclipse earlier, they can move to IntelliJ, and by using these shortcuts, you will be able to code into IntelliJ very fast, as efficient as you were doing into IntelliJ, but in Eclipse, sorry. So as fast as you were doing into Eclipse, the same keywords, shortcuts you can use into your IntelliJ also, and you can increase your productivity. Okay, so after this slide, you will be like this guy. So the shortcuts which we have used, they will change completely. Some of them will remain same. So whatever I have not included in the next slides, those will be the shortcuts which will be same in both the platforms, like this Eclipse and the IntelliJ. Okay, it looks apart. Okay, so now whatever we were searching from Control H, that could be done in Control Shift F, but the key map should be IntelliJ. So for example, if you are a newbie and you are starting with your career with IntelliJ itself, so for that you might be using IntelliJ only. So just make it is window. Okay, so now all the shortcuts which we have mentioned here, so those might not work, because let's say if I open Control H, so Control H will not open the file find in path window, it will open something else now. So that is why I kept this slide in between. Anyways, keyword search will be done by Control Shift F. So Control Shift and F, it will open my same window which I was opening by using Control H. You can search anything you want here. Next is Control F12, that will open the method definitions, which whatever we were doing by using Control O, it will be done by Control F12. Here. So whatever method I have created, let's say I have created that product. So this get PLP which I was opening from Control O, I will be opening it from Control F12. Get reviews for PLP. See. So the same method can definitions you can open from by using Control F12. So this is the difference, Control O and Control F12. In my personal opinion, I would say that Eclipse shortcuts which are there, these are a little bit simple as compared to IntelliJ's, but still whatever is compatible to you, you can use that one. Next, deleting a row, let's say I want to delete this row. So for IntelliJ I was using Control D, I will use Control X here. See, it deleted the row. Okay, so Control Z, because I don't want to delete. So for deleting a row, Control X on a particular row. Next, Control Y can be also be used. So if you press Control Y, it will ask you whether you want to delete it or you want to redo it. Okay. Control Y to redo or to delete line. So if you want to delete line, you can delete line, you can use redo also. So this is another option which is being provided by IntelliJ. That same thing we were doing by using Control D. Now select a full word. So let's say most of the time we want to select this. So I need to click two times here. I just want to select this. So instead of that, just click Control W. So what it will do is Control W. It will select automatically your word. Want to use Control W. This is a very long text, Control W. Okay, so this is how we can code faster. Instead of clicking double two times, Control W is fine. Okay. because most of the time your hand will be your right hand will be on your mouse and your left hand will be on the keyboard. So that is why it is very simple to use Control W instead of selecting it by double click like this. Okay, so if you want to select the full file, it's Control W, it will select the full file, full class basically. Okay, Control W is very useful. Now replacing path, if you want to replace something, let's say if you want to replace whatever is being used. So earlier in Eclipse we were doing the Control H and then we were having the find window. Here we will be replacing it, so it is similar to this one, Control H, but it is for find. Now I am covering the replace path, so Control Shift and R. This will give you a window where it will search for that particular keyword and it will replace it also. So if I want to replace a CMS paragraph into my IMPACTSIS by training, so that could be done from here. So you replace all with replace, or you can, like everybody knows what a replace means. So you can replace the replace all also, you can use a replace also for replacing only one content. So most of the time what we do is we want to replace some 10 to 12 files, we want to replace something into those 10 to 12 files. So for that, this is a very useful shortcut, Control Shift R. Indentation again, so indentation was done by Control I there. Here we will be using Control Alt L, Control Alt and L. This will, it will indent the code. Okay, so whatever irregularities were there into the code, it will do it systematically and it will look beautiful. Control Alt L, I prefer Control I, the Intel G1, the Eclipse one, because it is a little bit simple. Next is find next. So find next will be done by F3. Find next means if I want to find a particular, let's say categories next, so I'll click on F3. It has nothing here. Open some other. It is not found. I need to open some file. Okay, anyways, it is this shortcut is for finding the next. So whatever post review method is next, you will find that one when you click on F3. Let me check here also. Yeah, I will be having a get method. Okay, see like this. So for post review, I had one method. So product detail is there. Now the next method is post review. Next method will be this post review. This post review like this. So wherever this post review method is called, it will be finding the next one from here, F3. Next is the usage search. So whatever we were doing by using Control G, basically I was doing it by clicking on Control and then click on that particular method. It is same. So Alt F7 will also do that. So yeah. So if I click here, Alt and F7, so it will also show me the usage of this particular method, where it is being used and how many times it is being used. Two usages are there, so that could be done from by using this also, Control and this particular into the method. So this is one more usage of it, Alt F7. So these were the shortcuts which were IntelliJ specific. Rest were the one which are same, like almost similar. So whatever I have covered here, I have mentioned, some of the new ones are also mentioned here. So these will be enough to start with your IntelliJ projects, and as you move forward, you will be becoming more comfortable into it. Next, regarding the debug, so most of the developers must be waiting for debug session to start. Okay. Sorry. So if you want to debug your Hybris project, let's say, so for that what you need to do, basically if you import it the way which I have shown in my previous video, which I have mentioned earlier, I'll give a link into that description also. If you go to that video and follow that steps, you don't need to change anything. You just need to start your server into debug mode. So for that, what you need to do is you just need to write that command into the platform, Hybris server, like this. Dot app space debug. So this is the command which you going to use to start your server into debug mode. Once your hybrid server is started into debug mode, you just press one breakpoint. Let's say I want to land here, let's say, for example, for my debug point, I just want my debug point to stop here. So this is my method definition. So for debug point, I have one already created one. I have already shown one shortcut, that is Control Shift B. Sorry, it will not be working here. I need to change the key map. So now I'm coming to Eclipse one because I'm more familiar with it. Okay, so Control Shift B. This is my breakpoint. To start with the debug, what you need to do is you will be having one icon here, the debug one. You can click it from here also and go to run, and then you can start from here also. Alt Shift F9 is one shortcut key also, but I will prefer this one. So I'll click on it. Right. So now my debug mode, like my server is in debug mode and my IntelliJ is also in debug mode. So by this command hybrid server.bat.space debug, I have started my server into debug mode. After that, I have started the debug in my IntelliJ also. So for debug, I need to be into one method. Let's say, okay. Let me change something. Okay. So this is my debug. Now I want to start my website. Let me check if my server is up. Okay. Server is up. I go to my electronics.local website. And I want to land on that particular controller by using debug. So sorry, it's taking time. It was not already running. So meanwhile, I can go through the shortcuts again. Control H, Control Shift F, Control F12. Okay, I'll explain this part also. Let's say if you're in IntelliJ, you want to change your debug port. If you want to change your port where you want to debug it, Tomcat port. So what you need to do is you need to search for Tomcat debug Java options, this property, and you need to put the value for it, the port here. So this is the property. I will mention it into the into my description also. But this is the port, this is the value which you need to change if you want to change the port. Anyways, if you follow that video and you start your IntelliJ by from there, there is no need to change the port mostly, but if this port is occupied, then you need to change it. Anyways, so okay, so I have landed here on my website. So what I'll do is I'll go to my PLP page. From there, I will be going to 1PDP. Okay, so I am on my PDP. Whenever I click on this, I will be going to my debug here. So I have reached to my debug point. So I have put my debug point here in this particular request mapping product code /p/product code. So I have hit that URL and I have landed here. Okay, so once you are into your debug window, what you need to do is you need to iterate through it, right? So for iterating, you need to use these shortcuts. F6 will be for step over. Step overs means if you need to go to the next step, F6. So once I click on F6, I will be moving to the next step. It will come here after clicking on F6. Okay, so now it came here. Okay, I think I have made some changes into my file. So that is my lines are up and down. What I'll do is I'll press Ctrl Z just to make everything one place. again I will be putting my debug point here, starting the debug again, and now I will be running on the same page. It makes no difference, basically just my lines were up and down because I was showing into my earlier slides I was covering this topic, so that is why. Oh no, I have put the debug at the wrong point. Just a second, I need to put it here. Again, so once I hit that particular request mapping, I have landed on my controller again. So this is my debug point, I have landed here. If I want to move to the next line, I will press F6. If I press F6, it will move to the next line. It'll come here, F6 again, F6 again, like this. So this is your step over. Step over means if you want to move to the next step. If you move to the next debug point, or if you want to move to the outside of your debug. Let's say I just want to skip everything and I want to go to this particular method. I want to stop here. What I'll do is I press F8. F8 will go to the next breakpoint. And since I don't have any other breakpoints, if I press F8 again, it will come out of the debug. Okay, boom. So I am out of debug. My page is being reloaded again. Yes, like this. Again, we'll see the next shortcut also. And I'll reload. I landed on my debug page. Now I want to step into this particular method. So there are two ways. Either I open this method by opening the implementation of it and I click one more debug point, or what I can do is I can press F5. F5 will go to the next step, into this method basically. It will go into this method, then F6 will go to the next next line. If I want to go into this method, I'll press again F5. So there are two methods, so I want to go into this one, F5. Now I'm moving to the next steps, like this. F6 again. Now data. I want to go into this method, particular method. What I'll do is F5 again. It will go into this method like this. So you can go through the code like this. So you can starting from F6, you will be iterating through lines. By clicking on F5, you will be going into that particular method, and by clicking on F8, you will move out of it. Okay. So things are done. Now evaluating an expression. Obviously we debug the code just to check what values we are getting in a particular code. So what I'll do is I will do my reload again. Now I want to check what value I'm getting here for some particular data. Now for this, what I'll be doing is I will be using a shortcut key, and IntelliJ also provides you with one facility that it will show you the details here itself. So product code is 347045, model is empty, and this is your request which is coming. This is the object, like this. So whatever, if you have gone through the code, then it will show the details like this. So encoded product code will be like this, model size is 9, like this. So this is the beauty of IntelliJ. It is showing you the details already. You don't need to evaluate the expression, but in case you want to evaluate, you want to check what is coming into this request. So for that, what you need to do is control, select the expression, control and U. Control U will give you the evaluate window. Select it, press enter. It will show you the details which you have. Now, if you want to, let's say, for example, if I go to this method, like this. So if you want to evaluate this particular service, control U, press enter, it will give you the service. You want to evaluate a particular method, let's say it's using the get product code method. What you can do is get.getProductCode, like this. You just need to mention the code also here. So whatever is coming in the context, you can press it, enter. So this will give you some this will evaluate your expression. This will show you like this. You can iterate from here also. You can open the context, full context, whatever method this particular object will be giving you, you can use those method in this evaluate window. So this is how you evaluate a particular expression. I need to check what request I'm getting. Control, that's it. Dot response object. Whatever I want to evaluate, I just need to select it. Press Control U. Product model. So this is my model. Dot get code. If I want to see what is my product code, get code. This is one particular method. Check the name, get name. So all these are the part of all these are the attributes of the product model. So whatever getter or setter we have here, get product code. So get code is a method here. So whatever method we have here, it could be used here also. So product model, evaluate it, and this will show all the details that product model is having. All the attributes are here, name like this, command attribute values, this. So whatever you want to fetch here, you want to see here, you can see from here in this evaluate window. Let's say if you want to drop this window, particularly if you are into debug window and you want to drop that frame. So for that there is one option, this one, drop frame. You can click on it. If you click on it, you will go to the starting drop. So starting window basically, frame. So this was my starting frame. I have started my debug from here. Now again I can evaluate. For example, I just want to see what I got here. But by mistake I clicked on F6 and I moved out. So I can do the drop frame and I can again go to the particular line. See, like this. So you can see debug is also fast here in IntelliJ. So this is also a good point of it. Some of you might not be Hybris developer, some of you might be only Java developers. So if you want to use the debug mode in Java for Java development also, then also you don't need to do anything. You just install IntelliJ, make your Java project, and you can start debugging directly. Just need to start your debug from here. This is the stop button, stop the debug, start the debug, put a breakpoint, run your program. You will land on that particular breakpoint if your code goes through. Okay, so this was all about debugging into IntelliJ. So I believe I have covered most of the shortcuts which were there, and somebody have requested regarding this particularly. Some people have mailed me, some have commented also, so I am just fulfilling your request. So this is my email ID, nithin.hybris@gmail.com. You can comment in this video also. You can reach out to me over this email ID also if you have any questions or concerns regarding this course. If you want me to cover a particular topic, just make sure that topic should be a little bit shorter, because I don't make long videos, and it is, should be for beginners so that they can learn. Thank you and have a nice day. I believe I have I have provided you some shortcuts for IntelliJ and some shortcuts for Eclipse. I believe if they should enhance your productivity. If they do, just drop a thumbs up, and please share this video so that I get encouraged to bring better content for you. Thank you and have a nice day.